It is well known that a house can be heated through a large window or through special walls which are heated by solar radiation to heat the house at night. Or we can collect heat from a sun-heated roof, or we can take it from pools or collectors in winter, or use other simple and cheap solutions. Unfortunately, all of this is only suitable for warm winters, but this video will describe the three best options for regions with cold winters, and these options must meet the following two main requirements. Firstly, solar energy should cover all heating needs of the house completely, 100% so that the owner of the house does not spend many thousands of dollars on the construction of a second heating system based on natural gas or a heat pump. Secondly, the cost of a complete solar home heating system should be less than $10,000 or $20,000 to win the competition from gas boilers and heat pumps and therefore dominate the markets in the future. I spent about $1,000 on building this solar station for space heating of this house. This mirror focuses solar radiation here, where the radiation heats 3 tons of water in this tank to approximately 80 degrees Celsius. I can take the thermal energy at any time through these pipes to heat the house at night and on cloudy days. My future videos will describe this system and the broader class of solar heaters whose mirrors are motionless from morning to evening. This class covers not only such devices with fixation of this receiver on mirrors, but also these more interesting solar heaters with fixation of receivers on the ground, with fixing mirrors, and with a cheap change in the location of the receiver. These 58 square meters of mirrors are capable of completely heating a house in the center of the United States, but not in my non-sunny Ukrainian climate, where the number of sunny hours in winter is almost 5 times less. These are the solutions for this region with cold but sunny winters, where approximately 40 million private houses require heating, and the cost of building home heating systems, maintaining them, and paying for natural gas and electricity for them amounts to about $70 billion annually. But these regions with warm winters require other technical solutions, which should be very simple and cheap, for example, those large windows, special walls, metal roofs, or other solutions. For example, my YouTube channel has already analyzed these options and this option of collecting heat due to cooling solar panels with air, but my future videos will describe more effective and cheaper solutions. Second place goes to a technical solution that involves buying a large number of solar collectors, which will heat several tons of water in this tank so that this thermal energy heats the house at night and on non-sunny days. Unfortunately, we have to spend between $20,000 and $50,000 to buy and install almost 100 square meters of factory solar collectors and other equipment. But temporary installation of similar cheap mirrors at the end of autumn and their removal at the end of winter reduces the number of solar collectors several times, and this effect of radically increasing their heat production was described by this my old video. Using homemade solar collectors reduces the total cost of the entire system to less than $10,000. Therefore, I plan to consistently analyze different types of homemade solar collectors and describe their capabilities in future videos, and for example, this my video analyzed the capabilities of this type of solar collectors for heating a house. This is a map of Japan, and our solutions are interesting here, and also here, in Korea, but these are regions with warm winters, where other types of solar home heating are more interesting. Unfortunately, our recommendations are not suitable for Europe because these are regions with warm winters and these are regions with cold but cloudy winters. Complete heating of a house here requires several hundred square meters of solar collectors and about this big a tank for hot water so that its thermal energy is sufficient to heat a house for several cloudy weeks in a row. Therefore, European houses require other technical solutions which will be described in my future videos, and for example, my next video will describe solar heaters which work in cloudy weather. Now, it seems that the best option is similar solar air heaters, and this my old video described one of the examples of solar air heaters made from aluminum cans. The sun heats the walls of the cans to a high temperature, which heats the air that circulates here. This hot air must pass through several cubic meters of gravel and heat it up, and this thermal energy will heat the house at night and on non-sunny days. My future videos will describe heating houses with other types of solar air heaters, for example, with other types of pipes, such simple heaters with air circulation between black and transparent surfaces, solar heaters with meshes, Similar heaters with a polymer or metal partition behind which the hot air circulates. These are cheap solar heaters, but their total area must be almost twice as large as in the previous case of our second place. In addition, they require such thick air pipes with thermal insulation and the proper use of the fans, so that their electricity consumption is low. This temporary installation of mirrors reduces the area of solar heaters many times and can increase the heating temperature of the gravel above 100 degrees Celsius, and my future videos are planning to describe these solutions.